Justin Jordan. This is Marcus Carey in Kentucky, but I'm at the Upper Texas Smokehouse here on my farm, and as promised, I want to show you my pit. This is the area where we're cooking, and that lid that you see open right there is my pit. Just built 2 weeks ago, and it's been performing marvelously. Let me show you how I made it. First of all, as you can tell, it's just concrete blocks. And what I did was I started off with a little 2-inch flat block at the bottom. Then I ran a course of block up and alternated so they interlocked all the way around. But I ran up 2 courses of block, and then here in the front I put a piece of angle iron. And that piece of angle iron does 2 things. It supports that middle block over the opening where I feed my fire, and it also helps to support the grate, which is a piece of expanded steel inside of here. And I had another piece of angle that I had to buy the whole length, so I had a piece cut off, and I just put it down the middle for extra support, because you know I'm going to load this up with pork meat. And when I got done running that 2 courses of block up to where the grate is and sat the grate on top, well, then I just went ahead and ran another course along the top and topped the whole thing off with 2-inch blocks. It looks like there's 1, 2, 3 blocks across the front, and 1, 2, 3, oh, looks like maybe 4 blocks along the side. Can't really tell over here. 3 blocks along the side. So it's 3x3 blocks. And right down here at the bottom, so that I can make my opening, just to show you, I used half blocks down there. That way my opening goes all the way to the floor. And you can see those 2-inch blocks sticking out down there. Well, I had some extras, so I went ahead and made myself a little hearth. Here in a minute, I'll show you how I set it up when we get it fired up so that it holds temperature, and how I can feed the fire and control my damper. Here's how I control the fire and control the air. On top of that hearth, I set another concrete block. Flat across the top of that, another 2-inch block. And then I can take this other little 2-inch block right here and move it up and close off my fire pit. It's not airtight, but it helps to control how much oxygen it is drawing. Then, of course, I got a 4x4 piece of steel here, and I've got it hanging from a cable from the ceiling so that I can have something help hold it open when I'm working on the pig meat. Back here it says it's 48 inches by 48 inches. It's 20 gauge steel. I just put a eyelet in there and a piece of cable up to my roof. I will tell you, I went ahead and put an exhaust fan in my cook shack because, well, it gets awful smoky in here, and that helps to get some of it out of here so I can breathe while I'm talking to people and making sure that everything is cooking just right. Oh, the last little piece of the puzzle. See these other little half blocks? I found that if I take those and set them just like this, and I'll show you here in a second. I know I'm wiggling around. If I set those little half blocks right there and then let that metal down off of that wire and let it rest right on the top of those after it gets a good bed of coals in there, it will hold temperature for 4 hours and I don't have to touch it. Well, that's about it from Kentucky, JJ. Listen, man, keep the faith, keep up the good work, and smoke some of that sweet meat. What do you say?